pause button symbology. Our teenage daughter recently discovered an ancient artifact. I blew the dust from its case and cracked it open. We called these cassette tapes. They contained music, sometimes collections of hand-selected songs. You mean like a playlist? Better, my child. Mixtapes. Mixtapes were their own art form and are probably best described by John Cusack's character in the film High Fidelity, adapted from the excellent book by Nick Hornby. Now, the making of a good compilation tape is a very subtle art. Many do's and don'ts. First of all, you're using somebody else's poetry to express how you feel. This is a delicate thing. Part of that subtlety is in the production. This wasn't dragging various tracks into a playlist like some pampered savage. You were recording tracks from vinyl, CDs, and other tapes onto a fresh cassette. To do this seamlessly, you relied on the pause button. It helped create a clean gap between the tracks. The record function would stay engaged, and then you unpaused playback for the length of the track. Another ancient relic also had a pause button. This had much larger cassettes and was called a VCR, or video cassette recorder. The first VCR remotes were connected by a long cable that wasn't quite long enough to reach your sectional sofa. The remote became a deadly tripwire, one the cat couldn't stop messing with. Up to that point, broadcasting as we knew it ran everything on a program schedule, meaning if your butt wasn't in front of the TV, you were going to miss your favorite show. The pause button provided the power of choice. We could choose when we were ready to view or listen. We could choose when we wanted to record it and watch it later. The pause button gave us the power to say, "Hold up there, powers that be. I'll consume your content when I'm good and ready." Never to be confused with stop. Pause is a momentary break in the action. Stop says, "We are done here." While pause says, "I need a minute." Stop would end the movie experience, and pause would freeze the frame, allowing you to pick up where you left off. Through the endless slipstream of information, pause is our sword and our shield. We can silence the chatter, halt, and redirect to what better serves us. We pause to look up what was said, to fact-check its authenticity. We can pause communication and relationships and pick them right back up, whereas stopping cuts them off entirely. Pause is our gateway into the gap and our exit point back to the action. When the children entered the wardrobe in C.S. Lewis's classic book, Narnia awaited while the world stood still. Pause gives us reprieve from the current onslaught or the power to hold on or savor it a bit longer. Like meditation practice, the pause is a deceptively active process. But when you become consciously aware that there is a pause button in any circumstance and that only your finger can activate or deactivate it, you realize the gravitas of the quote. Between stimulus and response, there is a space. In that space is our power to choose our response. In our response lies our growth and our freedom. That quote is typically attributed to Viktor Frankl. The jury's out on it could be a combination of Rollo May and Stephen Covey. So we pause, we chill, drop back into the mix with more wisdom and discernment.